So in this dramatic modern independent media hellscape, there are people seeking to make information more readily accessible and understandable. And then there are people who see the brand new $100,000 Hummer EV and go, hell yeah. For the latter half, Dan from the internet and the Damage Report present a look at these figures and what they're actually doing. Skip, get ready. We're diving into Griff Nation.
Griff Nation.
Okay, we're gonna have to stretch that intro, but yes. That was great. I love it. We're gonna have something more formal next time. But Dan is a connoisseur of right-wing grift. He's been identifying it and trying to stamp it out for a couple of years now. It's something that has bothered me for a long time. Almost as much as left-wing grift bothers me. But anyway, we've got a great tasty example of grift for you. And actually, some people might currently, as we're filming this, be watching this grifter standing behind what's left of Rudy Giuliani during his press conference. This is Jenna Ellis, senior legal advisor to Donald Trump. Now, if you're not familiar with Jenna Ellis, you're a normal, well-adjusted person. Congratulations. But if you spend a lot of time on Twitter, if you're very online, if your name is Ken Klippenstein, you've probably come across tweets like this. Thank you for having the courage to continue to fight for election integrity. We the people are proud of you, Mr. President. So for a long time, Jenna Ellis tweeted things like that. She was one of the many people, a lot of them blonde women, who just tweet nice things at the president and about the president and get like a following based on that. But that is before. Now, she is senior legal advisor to Donald Trump, actually at his big press conferences. But if you go back not all that long, not that many years ago, she had a very different opinion about Donald Trump, it turns out, when he wasn't paying her and when success and an audience and clout on the right wasn't 100% contingent on deference to the dear leader. Back in March of 2016, she put up this post, I believe on Facebook, saying, I could spend a full-time job just responding to the ridiculously illogical, inconsistent, and blatantly stupid arguments supporting Trump. But here's the thing. His supporters don't care about facts or logic. They aren't seeking truth. Trump probably could shoot someone in the middle of New York City and not lose support. And this is the cumulative reason why this nation is in such terrible shape. We don't have truth seekers. We have narcissists. And sometimes it even went beyond that with posts like this talking about how we're in the last days because of people like Donald Trump, people who are lovers of money, boastful, proud, abusive, disobedient, slanderous, unholy. Not lovers of the good, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God. Trump identified by her in 2015 as a lover of pleasure and not a lover of God. When he said he wasn't gonna be in one of the debates, she said, call his bluff. The debate would be better without him anyway. She said he can't handle criticism. This is insanely dangerous to the fundamental American value and inalienable right to freedom of speech. She thought that his comments about women were disgusting, and she was 100% right about that. Now, all of that was a few years ago before the Republican Party was consumed entirely by Trumpism and thus the shift. We're gonna get to her explanation in a second, but Dan, so far, what do you think about Jenna Ellis?
So there are a number of different kinds of grifters out there. You have the kind who's been a Republican all along and they decide to just like go wherever the wind blows and they land wherever the Republican Party is. And that's a savvy political move, sure. You have the brand of never Trumpers or like sometimes Trumpers like Ben Shapiro, who can be quoted in a sense scrubbed off the internet, but of course available on archives quote that goes something along like, if Republicans don't say no to Trump now, America will fall into like demagogic absurdity. Meanwhile, he spends every day, probably as we're recording this, basically running laps for that demagogic absurdity. You have that brand of grifter, but then you have, of course, the favorite, the why I left the left brand of grifter, let's say, who has this long history of being against, very strongly against all of the things that are logical to be against Donald Trump. We mentioned the sexism, we mentioned the inconsistency and the hypocrisy between the understanding of religion and tying to Christianity with Donald Trump's behavior. You see all of that, but then all of a sudden you get a pivot, and that pivot usually comes with money. And it happens so often that it's almost like played out. And the thing that is actually kind of sickening to me, besides the fact that she is getting some benefit out of this like financially, is that Jenna, she looks like one of these. She seems like one of these, what would be called now as sensational triggered libs, saying this is the end times. Donald Trump could shoot someone in New York and get away with it. 250,000 minimum Americans are dead of COVID, and Trump is nowhere near any sort of accountability for that. And you're working for him now. And you thought that he was gonna bring out the end times like 5 years ago. So not only did you think that he was gonna bring about the end times, you decided to join team end times. And so that along with being a grifter, makes you kind of a despicable person.
Yeah. Yeah, you join Team End Times because it turns out Team End Times has deep pockets and is supported by a base of people who don't necessarily have deep pockets, but will give whatever they find in their pockets. And this is what you see. The huge shifts when you perceive an audience and a way to cash in. The fundamental element of grift. There's other related things, the victim complex and all of that. But she was very clear about what Trump represented. And the thing is, she was accurate about all of those criticisms. There were Republicans who hated Trump, but weren't necessarily willing to criticize his worst elements because they, still being conservatives, are okay with some of that. They just would prefer that Ted Cruz is the president rather than Trump, that sort of thing. She correctly identified much of the problems with him, but now she's being paid. I don't know how much, but senior legal aid, probably a good amount. I mean, Rudy's making $20,000 a day, apparently. But that's what, Dan?
Can I just say one last thing? Because Donald Trump, we knew this from the beginning. He's the I need loyalty, I expect loyalty person. Well, he's whittled down his administration to so few people that loyalty is now fleeting. Because these things are very easy to pull up. If there are any sort of like opposition research or like vetting that happened in the Trump administration, these things would have pulled up pretty easily. But apparently her ability to be loyal now in this point trumps literally the past like record of things she said against Trump that seemed very disloyal. So it just kind of goes to show where the Trump administration is at a point where they're like looking for people to work with very quickly and desperately. But yeah, it kind of just goes to show the level of desperation they're willing to go to. Yeah. And it's fun to watch where not so morbid. Again, 250,000 people are dead.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.